Hello, welcome to this lecture video. In this video, I am going to explain elastic properties of materials and torsion of a cylinder. So, I am going to discuss the following points here. That is, torsional pendulum, expression for twisting couple in a wire or torsion of a cylinder. Now, what is torsional pendulum? So, you are going to look at a torsional pendulum in this picture. So, a wire which is fixed at one end and the other end is fixed with a rigid body which is circular in nature. Let L be the total length of the wire and R be the radius of the wire. So, these were all the informations about the pendulum that you are looking in this picture. So, consider a straight uniform wire whose one end is fixed to a rigid support and its other end is fixed with a rigid body. If the suspended body is rotated slightly around the wire as its axis, then the wire gets twisted. When the body is let free, then because of the elastic property of the material, it undergo regular to and fro turning motion around the wire as its axis. Such a type of oscillations are called torsional oscillations, and the setup is considered as torsional pendulum. So this is what the meaning of torsional pendulum. So, torsional pendulums were all having many applications. It is possible to calculate the moment of inertia of regular bodies as well as irregular bodies, and also it is possible to determine rigidity modulus of the wire if it is taken in the form of wire. So, these were all some of the applications of torsional pendulum. Next, torsion of a cylinder or expression for twisting couple in a wire. So, here you can look at a picture. A wire is considered as a cylinder. So, I am going to give you the explanation about this picture. So, consider a long cylindrical rod of length L and of radius capital R. That's what you can look at in this picture. Let O dash be its axis. We can imagine the cylindrical rod to be made out of thin concentric hollow cylindrical layers, each of thickness dr. If the rod is twisted at its lower end, then the concentric layers slide one over the other. This moment will be zero at the fixed end and it gradually increases along the downward direction. Let us consider one concentric circular layer of radius small r and of thickness dr. Let us consider a point that is capital A at the top which is fixed, and a point like B at its bottom shifts to B dash. So, because of twisting motion, the point B is shifted from B to B dash. So, here the angle BA B dash is equal to theta and the angle BO B dash is found to be phi. Therefore, the length of the arc BB dash can be written as small r into phi, or it can be written as L into theta. So, these were all the information about this picture. So, here the arc BB dash is equal to r phi. Consider that as equation number 1, and phi is considered as angle of twisting and L is length of the wire or cylinder, and capital R is the radius of the wire and small r is the radius of hollow cylindrical wire. If theta be the shearing angle, then the arc BB dash is equal to L theta. Consider that as equation number 2. From 1 and 2, we can write L theta is equal to R phi. Therefore, shearing strain is equal to R phi by L. But shearing stress is equal to rigidity modulus into shearing strain. That is nothing but N into R phi by L. If A is the area of cross section of the wire, then shearing force acting on it is given by shearing force is equal to shearing stress into area of cross section. That is N into R phi by L into A. Also, area over which shearing force acts, that is A is equal to circumference into thickness, that is equal to 2 pi r into dr. Therefore, shearing force acting is equal to N into R phi by L into 2 pi r dr. Further, moment of force acting on the wire about the axis O dash is equal to force into distance, that is equal to n into r phi by l into 2 pi r dr into r, that is equal to n phi by l into 2 pi r cube dr. Consider that as equation number 4. The total moment of the force acting on the cylindrical wire is equal to integration 0 to r n phi by l 2 pi r cube dr. Therefore, couple acting on the wire due to the torque is considered as C is equal to 2 n pi phi by l into r to the power of 4 by 4 between the limit 0 and r. So, after applying the limits, the value of C is equal to n pi phi r to the power of 4 by 2l. Therefore, couple per unit twist is given by C is equal to couple acting on the wire divided by angle of twisting, that is C is equal to n pi phi r to the power of 4 by 2l whole divided by phi. Here phi cancels, therefore C is equal to n pi r to the power of 4 by l. So, the value of C is calculated as n pi r to the power of 4 by 2l. So, the problem number 1 is calculate the angular twist of a wire of length 0.3 meter and radius of cross section 0.22 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter when a torque of 5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 newton meter is applied. Rigidity modulus of the material is equal to 8.2 into 10 to the power of 10 newton per meter square. So, as per the problem, the given data is L is equal to 0.3 meter, R is equal to 0.22 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meter, and rigidity modulus N is equal to 8.2 into 10 to the power of 10 newton per meter square, and torque T is equal to 5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 newton meter. So, here we have to calculate the angular twist theta. So, as according to the formula, the angular twist, that is theta, is given by, so torque T is equal to C into theta. So, the value of C is found to be pi n r to the power of 4 by 2l. Therefore, the value of theta is given by 2tl by pi n r to the power of 4. Now, substitute the value of tl n and r to the power of 4 here, that is 2 into 5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 into 0.3 divided by pi into 8.2 into 10 to the power of 10 into 0.22 into 10 to the power of minus 3 whole to the power of 4. So, on calculating all these, we are going to get the value for theta is equal to 0.497 radian. So, this is what the value for the angular twist after calculating the values. The next problem is problem number 2. A brass bar of length 1 meter and 0.01 meter square in section is clamped firmly in a horizontal position at one end. A weight of 1 kg is applied at the other end. What depression would be produced when the Young's modulus of the brass is equal to 9.78 into 10 to the power of 10 newton per meter square? So, this is what the problem. So, here the given data is L is equal to 1 meter and B into D, that is breadth into thickness, is equal to 0.01 meter square. So, here B is equal to D, that is equal to 0.1 meter, and F is equal to W, that is equal to 1 kg, and the weight will be nothing but 1 into 9.8, that is mass into acceleration due to gravity, that is 1 into 9.8, so many newtons. And the Young's modulus is taken as 9.78 into 10 to the power of 10 newton per meter square. So, what is the value of H here? That is how much depression will be produced because of the load applied. So, we know that the depression H is given by 4WL3 by YBDQ. So, substitute the values in the formula, that is 4 into 1 into 9.8 into 1 cube divided by 9.78 into 10 to the power of 10 into 0.1 into 0.1 whole cube. So, these are all the parameters substituted. So, after calculation, we are going to get the value for H is equal to 0.008 into 10 to the power of minus 6 meter. So, this is what the data we are going to get after calculating this.